Students, in today's session, I am going to discuss trick for balancing redox reactions in basic medium. To balance a redox reaction, 5 things you should know. Tip number 1, find oxidation number. Take the skeleton equation and find oxidation number of atoms and just identify whether the oxidation number of an atom is increasing or decreasing in that reaction. Step number 2. Just after finding the increase or decrease in oxidation number, to balance increase or decreasing, just you multiply with a suitable number. Suppose in one chromium or Fe is there, suppose Fe is there, its oxidation number is increased from 2 to 3. Then what is the change here? 1. And another X is there. X changed to Y. And its oxidation number is here is 3. And it's changed to 1. So here what is the change? Change is 2. In this change is 2. In this change is 1. So what you do is multiply this 1 with this equation and this 2 with this equation so that you can balance both the reactions. Step number 3, balance all the atoms other than hydrogen and oxygen. Next, step number 4, you already balanced all other atoms other than hydrogen and oxygen. So next thing is you have to balance oxygen. For balancing oxygen, just you add OH minus ion to the deficient side. Means suppose if right hand side is deficient in oxygen, then add OH minus to the right hand side. Next, after balancing the oxygen, then balance hydrogen. To balance hydrogen, what you do is add H2O molecules to the deficient side. Suppose if right hand side is deficient, then you add water to the right hand side. Suppose you are adding water to the right hand side to balance only hydrogen, but water consists of H plus ions and OH minus ion. So not only H plus ion, you are adding an extra OH minus ion. So what you do is just add same number of OH minus ions to the opposite side. That's why I wrote here add OH minus ion to the left hand side, because your right hand side is deficient in hydrogen. So you are adding not only hydrogen, you are adding extra OH, means you are adding water. That's why add OH minus to the opposite side. Is it clear? Once again, see, first thing is you write the skeleton equation, then find the oxidation number. After finding the oxidation number, just identify increase or decrease in oxidation number. Next thing is to balance the increase or decrease in oxidation number, just multiply with a suitable number. Next, balance all the atoms other than hydrogen and oxygen. For balancing oxygen, what you have to do, you have to add OH minus ions to the deficient side. To balance hydrogen, what you have to do, you have to add water molecules to the deficient side of hydrogen. At the same time, you have to add an extra OH minus ions to the opposite side. Now, let us take one example and try to balance that reaction. This is the example I'm taking. Step 1 is just find the oxidation number for this. What is step 1, students? Find oxidation number of chromium here. It is plus 3, plus 5, minus 1, plus 6. I hope you know how to find oxidation number, because you are maybe my subscriber. I already uploaded a video on tips to find oxidation number. If you still don't know the way to find oxidation number, once go through my channel. Here we found the oxidation numbers. After that, just you identify chromium here, it is in plus 3 and it is changed to plus 6. Means how much oxidation number increases here? Oxidation number is increased by 3 units. And here plus 3 to minus 1 means oxidation number is decreased by 6 units. Because plus 5 to minus 1, total change is 6 units. After finding that, what is our step 2, students? What is our step 2? Just to balance increase or decrease in oxidation number, you have to multiply with suitable number. So what you do is just multiply here Cr OH thrice plus IO3 minus, this is the equation I am taking. What you do here, it is 3, here it is 2, so multiply this with 2 means multiply Cr with 2 because it is increased by 3, it is decreased by 6. So if I multiply with 2, both becomes same. Then 3 2s are 6, so I'll multiply with 2 here. Next, step number 3. Balance all atoms other than hydrogen and oxygen. Chromium 2. So here I'll put 2. Iodine is already 1-1 balanced, and next balance hydrogen and oxygen. For balancing oxygen, what you should add, you have to add OH minus. Here how many oxygens are there? 3 2s are 6 plus 3, total 9. Here 2 4s are 8, means here 9, here 8. This side is deficient, right? My RHS is deficient in oxygen, so I'll put OH minus towards right hand side. See, I'm doing step by step so that you can understand it well. When you are practicing first time or second time, just go through like this directly. Don't do directly. Step by step you do. After doing 2 to 3 times, then you can, by seeing a reaction, you can balance it. No need of doing step by step. Next, balance hydrogens. Here, how many hydrogens are there? 3 2s are 6. And here only 1. So how many deficient towards right hand side? 5 are deficient. So add 5 H2O to the right hand side. 2 CrOH thrice plus IO3 minus gives rise to I minus plus 2 CrO4 2 minus plus OH minus. How many water molecules, students? 5. 5, because 5 hydrogens are deficient toward this side, and what I told you, at the same time you add 5 OH minus opposite side, 5 OH minus. And here what is common? 1 OH and 1 OH gets cancelled. What will be left? 4. Now, 2, write the final equation. 2 CrOH thrice plus IO3 minus gives rise to I minus plus 2 CrO4 2 minus plus 5 H2O. This is the balanced redox reaction in basic medium. See, I already uploaded a video on balancing redox reaction basic medium. There I discussed, suppose a reaction is there in acidic medium, directly you can convert into basic medium. I uploaded that. And here in this session, I discussed oxidation number method. I discussed oxidation number method, oxidation number method. And in my next video, I'm going to discuss ion electron method. Thanks for watching this video. I hope this will be useful for you. Thank you all for loving my videos.